shall see Jesus in the air, coming after you and me. Joy is ours to share. What rejoicing there will be when the saints shall rise, heading for that jubilee yonder in the sky. Well, Savior in the sky. It seems that now I almost see all the sainted dead rising for that jubilee that is just ahead. In the twinkling of an eye, change with them to be. For the living saints who fly to that jubilee will all Savior in the sky. Now it's with all that heavenly host we begin to sing, singing in the Holy Ghost how the heavens will ring. Billions there will join that song, with them we shall be praising Christ through ages long. Heaven's jubilee, well, oh, what singing. Morning when we all shall rise. Oh, what glory, hallelujah, when we meet our blessed Savior in the sky. I said, oh, what singing, oh, what shouting, on that happy morning when we all shall rise. Oh, what glory, Savior in the sky.
Amen. What a happy day that will be. Praise the Lord for his promises. Amen. Good morning. It's good to see everyone this morning. What a beautiful day we have to worship the Lord together. So good to see everyone out this morning. So great to be in the house of the Lord with God's people. There's no greater family, I've said it before, than the family of God. And it's so good to see everyone. We welcome everyone this morning. We hope you have felt welcome and so thankful for God's presence in our midst and looking forward to what God has in store for us. You know, we just get encouraged, or I get encouraged when I get to be with God's people and hear God, the preaching of the word, and I need that. You know, we live in troubling times. I don't think I need to tell any. Right. But you know, there's a promise in the Bible, and to me, it's one of the greatest promises that ever is given. It was some of the last words that Jesus spoke, and he said in Matthew 28, "And lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world." I'm so thankful that Jesus will never leave us nor forsake us, and he's with us, and he'll see us through. He's faithful. So let's look to him this morning as we open with some prayer. Our precious Heavenly Father, we do praise you. We thank you, Lord, for your faithfulness. We thank you, Lord, for your word that never changes. We thank you, Lord, that you never change, and Lord, that your word is still true today. And Lord, we've gathered together, Lord, to worship you, Lord, to give you praise, to give you thanks. And Lord, we've come to hear from you. We pray, Holy Spirit, speak in a mighty way. And Lord, may you receive all glory, honor, and praise for anything that's accomplished here today. And Lord, we pray especially right now for souls to be saved. We pray that either here in the sanctuary and also via the live stream, Lord, through the radio, we just pray, Lord, that you would move. And Lord, we know that, Lord, you have the power to save and to set free. And so, Lord, we just commit the service into your hands. May you be glorified, and may your will be accomplished, we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Good morning, everyone. It is a blessing once again to be in the house of God. We're glad that you're here. I'm glad to be here anyway. And we're just going to do some things this morning and just worship the Lord and the beauty of His holiness. If you are watching via live stream, we want to welcome you into our worship service as well. We want you to settle back and just settle in and worship the Lord right along with us. Sing, praise the Lord, and our pastor is going to preach here in just a little bit. If you're listening on 87.7, we welcome you into our worship service. And if you're wondering what's going on inside, then just get out of your car and come on in. Amen?
Amen.
But let's all stand this morning. We're going to sing "I Want to Know More About My Lord." While traveling through this world of sorrow, I'm on my way to glory land. I'll not turn back for some tomorrow. My trials here I'll understand.
Heaven!
Amen. That's old, but that's good. Just a quick announcement. Don't forget about the offering. You don't want to miss out on that worship. Just like you wouldn't want to miss out on the worship we've had this morning. Bear with me, because there's been a lot of prayer requests. So, Joyce Angel is at home. Bill Moon needs our prayer. Jim Pearson has more tests on his heart, so remember him. Ben Bowman needs our prayer. Charlana and Kevin Farley. Yvonne Cox. Paul and Mitzi Deaton. Robin Ballard, she's having a lot of trouble with her back, so remember her. Mark McLaughlin, Kenny Watkins with the COPD, Paul and Sue Bruns, Betty Corwin is in hospice care, then Jewel Weiss is having bad headaches. I know they would probably love to be here, but remember her. And I've got a few more. Marcy Smith, this lady has lesions on her brain, a tumor on her left kidney, metastatic lesions on her gallbladder, pancreas and lungs. She has three daughters, and her husband and her have a very positive attitude. So, amen. God can touch. Her list is long, but that's all right. Jessica Swan is a teacher at Valley View. She is a mother of a young son. She has stage 4 breast and lung cancer. So. Oh, did she? Okay, so remember this family. Connor Williams is in intensive care at Cincinnati Children's. He is a special needs young man. He is battling pneumonia after a procedure. So there's a lot looking to us for prayer. I want to read a quick verse in the Bible before we all come to the altar. It says, "In this world ye shall have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world." There's nothing too big for God. This list is long, but it's not too long for our Lord. Yes. Yes, we are. So those that can, would you stand and gather around the altars? Pick one of these prayer requests out in your mind and remember them. Yes. Because if you don't pray for them, who is going to? Yes. Brother Bob McCarty, would you come?
Weak in body, but strong in the spirit. Many requests this morning. I have several. Brother-in-law is going to have an MRA. That's what they're going to check. His aorta. He's got an aneurysm, I think. Sister having MRI and a CAT scan. She's got some kind of a stroke or something she's had. Seems like the enemy's on all sides. The Bible said when the enemy comes in like a flood, God will raise up a standard. I'm thankful this morning I'm serving a God that's able to do that. I've been down, but I'm up. Amen. You can't whip a man that don't stay down. You got to keep on moving for the Lord. So this morning I want to encourage anybody and by what live stream this morning, if you put your trust in God, He'll bring you through. I'm glad this morning He's bringing me through. Heavenly Father, we come before You this morning. Oh, we're not bragging on self. Self has been a mess all along. But Lord, You grabbed us up and took us when we wasn't nothing. And Lord, when we was filthy rags, He looked beyond our faults and seen our need. We need a Savior. God, we know this morning there's people sick. There's a mile-long list of churches that's got people sick everywhere. But I'm telling you this morning, we can touch the throne of God this morning. We're not beaten down. We're not running over. But we're royal priesthoods in Christ Jesus. I'm glad this morning we are peculiar people. When we have been down, we get back up. God, we're glad this morning we're serving a God that's never failed. He, the winds obey Him. Oh, the waves obey Him. Everything, the birds in the air, He made everything, the God I serve. This morning He made man. He made man to be a living soul. We were born to serve God. That's the reason that we're gathered in the house of God this morning. We're not here to be seen and be heard, but we'll listen to that still small voice. Said, go on. This is the way. Walk ye in it. Fill our pastor with the Spirit of God. Pour out the vessel this morning till it's running over this morning. Bless the singer. Everyone that has a breath, praise the Lord this morning. God, we're glad this morning. Oh, you look around and you seen broken pieces. I was a mess. I was in the potter's field when you picked the basket up in the midnight hour of my life. And you began to put me together. And I was faded in chips. You know where every piece is of everybody's life. And you started to put me together. And oh, that precious hand with the blood dripping on it, it brought life to me. Oh, out of that side, the church came out the water and the blood. And when you died at Calvary, all my sins were forgiven along with everybody else's. And not only that, when the Father raised you from the grave, that same Spirit you raised Him up with lives in me this morning. Ain't a thrill in my heart this morning to know the Holy Ghost is living inside of me. When I pray, when I lay hands on people, it's not me, it's that Spirit inside of me. This morning, I'm honored to be a child of God. I'm thankful to be in God's house. I'm glad when they said, go to the house of the Lord. Oh, what a thrill it is to hear the Word of God and to hear it sung. God, we know this morning without a shadow of a doubt. You're in my life this morning. If I never breathe another breath, I know where I'm going. I know who I am. Glory to God. We can know this morning. Oh, man, we know because a Redeemer has given us the power to be raised up. And the Redeemer liveth this morning. I know this morning I've been changed. And I thank you for the blessings of life and a beautiful day for the Lord to come. In Jesus' name, amen.
He's my name. First time I've sung this song. I tell a group all the time I don't like to lead too much, and they want to get me involved, and they try to do that, and I get so nervous when I do this. I don't know why. You would think being up here on the platform sometimes you wouldn't get nervous, but every time I do something for God, I always try to do my best. And John, if you can turn that piano on, I think maybe it's not plugged in or something. But I was thinking this week, and I don't want to sit up here and complain, because I really don't want to do that. But the Bible says in that 10th chapter of Matthew, I think somewhere down about the 34th verse, 35th verse, somewhere like that, it said that he didn't come to bring peace but a sword. Then he said, think not that I have come to bring peace. I didn't come to bring peace but a sword. And then he goes on to say, he said, because I'll set a man at variance against his father, and a mother against her daughter, and a mother-in-law against her daughter-in-law. And a man's foes will be they of his own household. And you know, a lot of times it is. It seems like that way. It seems like the devil just fights you on every front. But he goes on to say, he said, if you love father and mother more than me, you're not worthy of me. If you love son or daughter more than me, you're not worthy of me. And if you won't pick up your cross and follow me, you're not worthy of me. And I'll tell you, sometimes the very people that you think should support you don't. And I'll tell you, it does hurt sometimes. But I have made up my mind. I'm going to serve God. I don't care who comes against me. Amen. Just like that song says, I'm gonna go all the way through.
Yes.
And I hope I can get people to go with me, but if they don't, I'm going to go anyway.
Amen.
Then he goes on to say in that verse, he says, he that saves his life will lose it. He that loses his life for my name's sake will find it. And I'm going to tell you something. I want to lose myself for him.
Yes.
And I don't know how this song goes, but this song talks about the prodigal son. And you know, I know a lot of people in this life right now that are living that story. That's why it's so prevalent, even in today's time. There's so many people that have went away from God. They don't even realize it sometimes, but they just slip. A little bit at a time, they miss a service here, miss a service here, and before you know it, you're back to doing the things. In fact, your house is 7 times worse than it was when you started.
That's right.
And there's so many people like that today, and I don't know if I'll do this song justice. It's not a hard song, but it's a hard song for me. So pray for me that I'll do that. It just says, tired of sin. And I wish people would just get tired of sin and run back to the Father's house, because we need that today. And I hope and pray that you'll pray for us today.
Is back home again. not worthy, you see. If you let me come home, I'll be a servant for thee. I've lost all I had.
This song in a while either, but I can say that I've been blessed. Even with all the problems we face, God sure has blessed my life. And one thing He's blessed me with is I don't have to fear anymore. No matter what comes my way, I don't have to fear, because He's with me, and I'm thankful for that today.
Can listen.
Let's make welcome our pastor.
We are blessed. We are blessed in heavenly places this morning. Thank God by the power that raised Jesus from the dead, we're raised up. That we are in Him, and it's through Him that we live and move and have our being. We're here today because He lives. He reigns, and thank God, greater is He that's in us than he that's in the world. And you know, I hear those words, we're in troubling times, but I tell you what, thank God we have the one who is above all the troubles. And in Him, we are blessed. In the Bible, the prophecies of Joel were given by God during a time of great plague, during a time of a season of drought. And Joel gave the message of God, calling all men and women to repentance and deliverance by faith in God. Joel is quoted in the New Testament by the apostles Peter and Paul. And probably the most well-known was when Peter, on the day of Pentecost, you remember, the Spirit of God poured upon the church. Those believers, they were turned loose. And they went out preaching. And the Spirit of God was moving through them. And folk, I want to tell you, we're living today, we need to see the Spirit of God move. And we need to see the Spirit of God move through the church. You remember when Peter stood, he said in Acts 2:16, he said, "But this is that which was spoken by the prophet Joel. And it shall come to pass in the last days, saith God, I will pour out of my Spirit upon all flesh. And your sons and daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. And on my servants and on my handmaidens I will pour out in those days of my Spirit, and they shall prophesy." And that's exactly what they were doing. And it goes on to say in verse 21, "And it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved." How many know that prophecy is still being fulfilled today? The Holy Spirit is still drawing men and women to Christ. He's still working. And friend, I want to tell you, there's coming a day where God's going to say, enough. Our work is done. And friend, I believe we got to be getting ready for that moment. The trump of God is going to sound. I want you to turn with me in your Bible to the book of Joel. Joel, the second chapter. We begin this morning in verse 1. Joel chapter 2, verse 1. "Blow ye the trumpet in Zion, and sound an alarm in my holy mountain. Let all the inhabitants of the land tremble, for the day of the Lord cometh, for it is nigh at hand." Verse 12, "Therefore also now, saith the Lord, turn ye even to me with all your heart, and with fasting, and with weeping, and with mourning. And rend your heart, and not your garments, and turn unto the Lord your God, for He is gracious and merciful, slow to anger, and great mercy, great kindness, and repenteth Him of the evil." Verse 15, "Blow the trumpet in Zion, sanctify a fast, call a solemn assembly." Our message this morning is entitled, "When the Trumpet Sounds." When the trumpet sounds. Let's pray. Father, we thank You for Your Word. We ask, Spirit of the living God, that You would breathe life and power upon Your Word, that it would find a place in every heart. We pray a rebuke against the enemy of our souls, and we pray You would encourage those that might be down this morning or discouraged. Heal those that are sick and suffering, and set every captive free. We pray the gospel would go forth today. Lord, build Your church and bless Your people and feed Your flock. And Father, help us to get ready, for the coming of the Lord is drawing nigh. So Father, we thank You. God, You're faithful. We're trusting You. Lord, may we have revival this morning. May the Spirit of the Lord have free course. Lord, we give You permission to move upon us, upon our hearts. Lord, I give You permission to move through my life. I'm Yours. I surrender to You. And so, Father, we pray, save somebody in Jesus' name. God's people said, amen, amen. Sounding the alarm is needful in the day we're living. If the fire station alarm goes off across the street, that means there's a fire or there's an emergency and requires immediate attention. If the tornado or bad weather siren goes off, we know it's time to take cover. If your alarm clock goes off, time to get up, not hit the snooze button, right? Well, how many know there are trumpets in the Bible? Trumpets of God. We're here and we're told this morning in Joel, the second chapter, says, blow ye the trumpet in Zion. Sound an alarm in my holy mountain. Let all the inhabitants of the land tremble, for the day of the Lord cometh, for it is nigh at hand. Now we know that Zion represents the church. She's the city of God, which is on the mountain, not down in the valley. And so blowing the trumpet in Zion would represent sounding alarm, the trumpet of truth, calling all men and women, young and old, to come together before the Lord. Prepare ourselves for the Lord's coming. Folks, we live in a day where people need to wake up out of spiritual slumber, to fire up out of a lukewarm condition. The church needs to lift up the standard of God by the power of His Word and by the sword of the Spirit. There's a question asked in Jeremiah 4:21, how long shall I see the standard and hear the sound of the trumpet? How long? That alarm needs sounded today. Folk, if there's one thing that's needed today, people need to get ready to meet God. We need to get ready for the second coming of Christ. We need to get ready for the judgment seat of Christ. He's coming. Mark my words, my friend. He's going to be right on time. When God says it's time, Jesus is coming back. Amos the prophet, he warns us in Amos 4:12. He simply says these words, prepare to meet thy God. Prepare to meet thy God. Now the devil certainly does not want us to heed the alarm. The devil doesn't want people to be ready. Things that are going on today, I believe, are trying to silence the trumpet. People don't want to hear the trumpet of God. They don't want to hear the truth of God. They don't want to be called before God. But I can tell you, my friend, there'll come a day where every man, woman, boy, or girl, alive and dead, is going to stand before God Almighty. And so we need to hear the trumpet. We need to hear the sound of the trumpet. We need to know what we're called to. First of all, God is calling us through the trumpet. He's calling us to unity. God is calling through the trumpet of unity. I want you to notice in Joel here, verse 1, he says, blow ye the trumpet in Zion, sound an alarm in my holy mountain, let all the inhabitants of the land tremble, for the day of the Lord cometh, for it is nigh at hand. In other words, the trumpet of God sounds the call to unity. Unity of believers. Unity of all the saved. We are to be of one heart and one mind. We are called by God as the people of God. I don't care where you've come from. I care where you're going. And I can tell you this morning, my friend, God wants to put you in the body of Christ. He wants to save you, forgive you, cleanse you from sin. He wants to purify you with His Spirit. He wants to make you one with Christ. And when we're one with Christ, we are one with another. How many know division and separation harms the church? It not only harms the church, but it'll hinder the progress and purpose to which we are called. When Paul to the church in Corinth, he wrote in 1 Corinthians 1, chapter 1, verse 10, he said, now I beseech you, brethren, by the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, that you all speak the same thing, that there, notice, there be no divisions among you, but that ye be perfectly joined together in the same mind and in the same judgment. Can I tell you, anything that separates or divides God's people is to be avoided. God's call on the gospel trumpet of truth is for all people everywhere to come out of sinful living, come out of separate attitudes, come out of being a selfish individual, come out of division, come out of strife, and come out of denominational dividedness. Come out from a spirit of separatedness. There is not one place in the entire Bible where the separation of God's people is encouraged. If you do, it will be at the expense of unity. Listen, Hebrews 10:24 says, let us consider one another to provoke unto love and to good works. That means that there is an action that takes place by us getting together. We encourage one another. We love on one another. Man, I can't wait till I can wrap my arms around you and give you a big hug. But then it says, not forsaking the assembly of ourselves together as the manner of some is, but exhorting one another so much the more as you see the day approaching. Friend, I want to tell you, the reason God says that His church is to be together is because when Christ comes, my friend, we will be caught up together in the air with Him. I'm afraid the devil is drawing many. He's trying to destroy many. Well, Jesus warned it. In John 10:10, Jesus warned, He said, the thief cometh not but to steal, to kill, and to destroy. In other words, the devil wants to do harm to the flock of God. He wants to divide the people of God, and then when he divides the people of God, he will try to conquer. He will try to take control. But Jesus says, I am come that they might have life and that they might have it more abundantly. You see, the power of the church has always been in her unity. Unity of the Spirit, unified by the Spirit. Just as it says in Ecclesiastes 4:12, if one prevail against him, two shall withstand him, and a threefold cord is not easily broken. I can tell you, when you've got a group of believers together, my friend, that is where the devil is defeated. I've often heard, don't be like the banana that gets split from the bunch. You know what happens to the banana that gets split from the bunch? It gets peeled and eaten. Doesn't it? Among the things listed that God hates in the Bible, you remember in Proverbs 6, it says, a false witness that speaketh lies, and he that soweth discord among the brethren. The trumpet of God sounds calling to unity. And here in Joel, Joel says, blow ye the trumpet in Zion, sanctify a fast, and call a solemn assembly. Notice the call is a sound the alarm. Wake up, sanctify a fast. That means let's get serious about God and this business which we're called to. Souls are at stake. Souls are in the balance of heaven and hell. People are bound by the devil. People are living in sin. And they need the power of the gospel to meet them where they're at. They need the light of God. And friend, that light's got to shine through you and I. It is a divine work of the Holy Spirit to save us and to put us into the body of Christ. We can't save anybody. You don't get saved by just repeating a prayer. If you're going to be born, you got to be born of the Spirit. Amen? And then the work of the Spirit is to sanctify and pure us. He purifies us. And I'm afraid that's where many of the churches fall short. They put all their emphasis on just getting people to Jesus. Friend, that's the start. That's where we begin. But friend, there's a whole process of growing in the Lord, growing in the grace and knowledge of Jesus Christ. But friend, there's the work, the deeper work of the Holy Spirit of God, sanctifying believers, purifying us from carnality. Man, that's a bad word. Carnality. Carnal division. Jealousies, bitterness, a different approach to Christianity. My heart is burdened this morning. It is important that we allow the Holy Spirit to work through the church. When Paul was pleading with the church in Ephesus, and by the way, it was that church that Jesus came to first in Revelation and warned them, they had left their first love. If people come back to church, it'll be because they love God more than anything else. It won't be because we can have good singing. It won't be because of a preacher. It won't be because of the pastor. It'll be because people are in love with God. And when people are in love with God, I want to tell you, then the devil's defeated. When Paul was pleading for unity in the church, notice he said in Ephesians 4:13, till we all come in the unity of the faith. They weren't there yet. And the knowledge of the Son of God unto a perfect man under the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ. It takes believers together to build the body of Christ. And the perfect man is the body of believers that are unified by the Spirit. That is the perfection of unity. God is calling us to a matured experience. And unity grows out of that experience. It's more than just saying, look, I'm a part of that church, or I go there. No, it's I belong to Christ. And because I am surrendered to Christ, Christ lives in me. He lives through me. My life is surrendered to Him. And friend, it is then you are automatically one with another. That we are unified. The baptism of the Holy Spirit, the Holy Ghost's work of entire sanctification deep in the heart of a believer, is the only thing that will bring this blessed experience. There is not unity without the Holy Spirit. You can have a club, you can have a meeting, you can call it a church, but I want to tell you, if the Holy Spirit is not in control, there is not divine unity. The trumpet needs to be sounded today. Men and women need to come out of sin, come out of darkness, come out of the world and live for Christ. Let go. Let God have control of your life. And we'll see what God can do. Secondly, we must hear the trumpet of God. The biblical call not only calling God's people to unity, but we need to hear the trumpet calling to battle. The trumpet of God is calling us to a battle. In the Bible, the trumpet was used to summon soldiers for the battle. It was used by Gideon to rally the troops of God, to sound the warning. It was used by Joshua. It was used by Nehemiah. You remember when they were building the wall. As a matter of fact, in Nehemiah 4:20 it says, in what place thereof ye hear the sound of the trumpet, resort ye thither unto us. Notice, our God shall fight for us. As Nehemiah and the people of God rebuilt the wall in Jerusalem, they had much opposition to overcome. But they had a mind to work. They had to watch and pray. They had a sword in one hand and a trowel in the other. And best of all, they had a God who fought for them. Friend, I'm going to tell you, I thank God that we too have a God, the same God that fought for Nehemiah, the same God that called the people of God together then, is the same God that calls us today. And they finished the wall too. It's true, when you arise and build for God and be a part of what God is doing, you enter the battle. When Paul to the church in Corinth said in 16:9 at the close of that epistle, he said, "For a great door and effectual is opened unto me." In other words, God is allowing me to spread the gospel. The work of God is prospering. But then he said, "And there are many adversaries." Friend, we've got to wake up and hear the trumpet of God. Joel reminds us, "Below you the trumpet in Zion, sound the alarm in my holy mountain. Let all the inhabitants of the land tremble. Why? For the day of the Lord cometh, for it is nigh at hand." We need to hear the sound of the trumpet calling us to battle. For what? We're battling for the right, for the truth, for the sake of the gospel, for the souls of men. We're standing for what God stands for. Will you arise and build with God, battle with God, battle and let God fight for us together? Paul said in 1 Corinthians 14:8, he said, "For if the trumpet give an uncertain sound, who shall prepare himself to the battle?" Can I tell you, heaven is at stake. Hell is in fury. Souls are in the weight and the balance, and many are wanting. We need to hear the sound of the gospel trumpet going forth today. Do you hear the trumpet calling? I hear the trumpet calling God's people to unity. Come out of division. Come out of strife. Come out of discouragement. Get amongst the people of God, where the Spirit of God dwells and moves in our midst. Several years ago, I heard someone make a statement. This was several years ago, and I disagreed with it, but now I'm seeing it happen. This person just simply made this statement: there's going to come a time where people are, all they're going to want is a church that's online. And I disagreed with that. I said, that will never happen. You can't keep God's people from meeting together. I thank God for the live stream, and I thank God there's people tuning in today, and we thank God for you. But friend, you cannot replace that with being here as a warm body. Why? Because it is our work that God uses us to bring the gospel to the lost. It's an all-out church effort. Finally, we hear the trumpet of God, and it's the biblical call. The Bible says there'll be a final trumpet that shall sound. As a matter of fact, it's called the last trump. You know where it's at. 1 Corinthians 15:51, it says, "Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump. For the trumpet shall sound," notice, "and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed." Glory to God. How many know there's no trump after the last trump? We're not talking about politics either. What I'm saying is there's no chance for salvation after the trumpet sounds. He goes on and says, "For this corruptible must put on incorruption. This mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall put on incorruption and this mortal shall put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying is written, death is swallowed up in victory. Oh, death, where is thy sting? Oh, grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin. The strength of sin is the law." But thank God they don't have the final word. It goes on in verse 57, but thanks be to God which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Friend, I got good news for you. When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound and time shall be no more, when the morning breaks eternal, bright and fair, when the saved of earth shall gather over on the other shore, when the roll is caught up yonder, I'll be there. Are you ready? You can be. You must be. On that bright and cloudless morning, when the dead in Christ shall rise, and the glory of His resurrection share, when His chosen ones shall gather over to their home beyond the skies, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. Don't you want to be there? Don't you want your loved ones to be there? The gospel trumpet is sounding today. God is calling men and women to arise. Come forth, come out from among those who linger in the world and linger in sin. Come to Christ. Give your life to Him now while there's yet time and you've got an opportunity. I'm afraid we often hear the Bible. We've heard preaching so much that it hardly affects people anymore. But the Bible warns in Proverbs 29:1, he that often, being often reproved, hardeneth his neck, shall suddenly be destroyed, and that without remedy. Let's not avoid the sound of the trumpet this morning. Do not miss your opportunity to hear and not respond would be detrimental. Respond now. Don't miss your opportunity. Don't delay. Don't put off. For God says here in Joel, in verse 12, He says, therefore also now saith the Lord, turn ye even to me with all your heart, with fasting, with weeping, and with mourning. And rend your heart and not your garments, and turn unto the Lord your God, for He is gracious, merciful, slow to anger, great kindness, and repenteth Him of the evil. Friend, Jesus has done everything He needs to save every soul. Not only here, but that's watching or listening. Wednesday night, as we had a time of altar service and prayer, and if you don't mind me sharing this, brother, you got up, I walked over and had prayer with Lori Carpenter here, and he is definitely a miracle of God. God has delivered you out of. And you looked at me, and I could tell you had something on your heart that you wanted to say to me. And you said, you know, God tried to get a hold of my life 40 years ago. And I refused. 40 years ago. And I said, well, thank God He gave you another chance. It's never too late. Moses didn't get saved until he was 80, and look what he did for God. Come, I plead. Come to Jesus while it is today. Do not grieve the Holy Spirit. Come, dear soul, while you may. There are some who once heard the call, and they no longer hear the call. God, you simply just go through the motions. There's some that need to have a vital relationship with Christ, to fall deeply in love with Christ. Can I tell you, His love will cast out all fear. You won't fear anything. You won't fear death. You won't fear the devil. You won't fear sickness. You won't fear disease. You lose fear. Why? Because your life is in His hands. You don't have to live in fear. He's risen from the grave. He's seated at the right hand of God. He makes intercession for each of us, even right now. Friend, the Holy Spirit is here. He's waiting on us to move. I plead with you, don't delay. Don't turn Him away. While there's yet time, and friend, while God has given us work to do, let's be faithful. We're going to have a song of invitation. I'm going to invite you to stand this morning. Would you bow your head in prayer as we stand? And do you hear God calling? Do you hear the trumpet of God calling you? Come forth. That alarm that goes off that the Holy Spirit is an awakening, folks. Bringing people to realization that God is on the throne. That Christ is the only way. And that whosoever shall call on Him shall be saved. There's no other name given among men whereby we must be saved. Would you come and humble your heart to Him? This morning, step out from where you are. Say, Lord, I'm answering the call. I hear you calling me. I want to work together with the people of God. I want to be in unity. Lord, cleanse us this morning. Purify us as your people. Make us one in Christ. Give us all one mind and one heart. Lord, we pray that you would open doors that no man could open. And we pray, Father, for the power of the Holy Spirit to rest upon each of our lives. Give us courage. Give us boldness. Help us to stand for Christ in this world that is, Lord, just seemingly quickly sliding downward away from God. Father, I pray this morning, may victory be won at these altars. Heal the broken heart. Put a rebuke upon the work of the devil. Lift those that are discouraged, set captives free. Lord, may names be recorded in the book of life. May the blood of Jesus cleanse every sin and make us free. Friend, now is your moment. Come quickly. Step out. Mom and Dad, you come, pray together. Parents, grandparents, pray. Pray for the church. Pray for those that are wayward. Pray. Let's pray this morning. May the Spirit of God breathe afresh upon us and do a fresh work. May He begin with you and me. If that's what you want, would you come and pray? Say, that's what I desire. More of Jesus than anything else. Let Him have His way. You come now as we begin to sing. You come right now.
Hear the blessed Savior calling thee oppressed. O ye heavy laden, come to me and rest. Come no longer tarry, I your load will bear. Bring me every burden, bring me every care. Come unto me. I will give you rest.
Lord, if you got someone on your heart this morning, by all means, come and pray for them. Maybe they're here this morning. Just step out, intercede for them. But how many feel like, I need a closer walk with God? I just need a closer walk. Take that step. He's right here waiting on you. Take that step towards Him. He's the same. He never changes. Let Him have His way. Would you come this morning? If you'd like to be anointed and prayed for, you come as well. We'll pray for you. Let's sing another verse.
Are you disappointed?
Amen. All hearts clear? Yeah. Come back tonight. If you want to encourage your pastor, be back tonight. It's encouraging to see your face. There is something about unity, being together. So, Ethan, would you dismiss us in prayer? We'll let our pastor and Julie go out. Ethan, will you dismiss us?